I am Milka Jagale, working as assistant professor in WALCHAND Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to see introduction to Scilab. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, student will be able to recognize various toolbars of Scilab software. So these are the contents of today's PPT. Free software, introduction to Scilab, environment of the Scilab, Scilab menu bar, Scilab features, Scilab operators, Scilab functions, Scilab toolbox. So let's see what is a free software. A software is known as a free software if it provides some kind of freedom. A software generally provides four kind of freedom to its user. First one, the freedom to run the software anywhere, any way. Second, the freedom to copy and distribute. Third, the freedom to access to the source code and the freedom to access to the source code of the software. The freedom to modify and redistribute. So let's see what is Scilab and what do you mean by Scilab. Scilab is pronounced as Sci, that is scientific, and Lab, laboratory. It is a free and open source software. It is user-friendly, numerical and computational package. Scilab is available for various operating systems such as Windows, Linux and Mac OS. So you can find out, you can find a free software on the website www.scilab.org and www.scilab.in. So figure 1 shows the Scilab logo. So as we have discussed, Scilab is a free and open source software. Scilab was created in 1990 by the researchers and it was initially named as Scilab. Due to free availability, users can see and modify the source code, redistribute and improve the source code and use the software for any purpose. So due to the free availability, researchers, institutions and academic individuals can take the benefit of the Scilab software. I just want to ask you a question. So you just think on why there is a necessity of Scilab or why you should choose the Scilab software. Just pause the video for a few seconds and think what is the necessity of Scilab and why you should choose Scilab software. So let's see, as we have discussed, it's a free and open source software. The syntax of the Scilab is very easy. Numerical problems can be easily solved with a reduced number of code lines as compared to traditional languages. There is a very large user community that uses and supports the Scilab by contributing in the form of mailing list, Usenet groups and websites. So let's see the environment of Scilab. Scilab consists of mainly four windows: console window, editor window, graphics window and help window. So let's see what is console window. So console window is a window for the calculation work. Editor window is used to write the programs. Graphic window is used to plot the graphs. When you want to plot a graph, a new window pop-ups where you can see the graph plotted on that graphic window. And help window, here you can ask the queries which you are facing during the Scilab functioning or Scilab operations. And there is also an offline mode where you can ask the questions and you can see the it's also have a function where you can function it very properly. So this is how the console window of Scilab looks. So here you see there's a variable browser, comment history, and there's a space for calculation work. This is the editor window of Scilab. Here programs are written and the execution is done. So graphics window of Scilab, 2D plot, 3D plots can be plotted on this graphic window. This is a help window of Scilab. If you have any doubt regarding any function, just type that function name in the search bar and you will get the detail of that functions in the help window. So these are the Scilab menu bar. So there are 6 menu bars in the Scilab. File menu, this is same as the other software packages which are used. Edit menu, in this edit menu you can cut, copy, paste, select all. Control menu, in this control menu you can resume, interrupt, or abort the functioning of the Scilab. Control preference menu, in this the color, font, and tool view bar history can be shown. Application menu, in this there is a Scilab to MATLAB converter, and in this application menu there is also Scicos Scilab to application. In the last menu there the last menu consists of the Scilab help. There you can it consists of Scilab demonstrations which are very easy for the beginners who are trying the first time operation on the Scilab. These are the Scilab features. Scilab can perform many features such as arithmetic, relational, logical, and matrix. Control systems, image and video processing, real-time control of hardware, interfacing, data acquisition, simulation, and plotting. Scilab can perform the following operations: arithmetic operations, relational or conditional operations, logical operations, matrix operation. The basic matrix operations like inverse, triangular, transpose, eigenvalues, and eigenvector operations. So these are the Scilab functions. Scilab consists of many functions like elementary functions, mathematical functions, logical like AND, OR, NOT, and complement, trigonometric functions like sine, cos, tan, inverse trigonometric functions, and hyperbolic functions. So these are the toolboxes which Scilab contributes. There are different toolboxes for different tasks such as Scilab image and video processing, Scicos, Labostat, Scilab wavelet toolbox, Scilab Java and .NET module, Scilab remote access module. So these are the references. Modeling and simulation in Scilab Scicos by Stephen Campbell. This is a book. And the book by Hema Chandran and Nair. Thank you.